I'll put the labor unions behind you. George Meany's labor crowd ought to be there tomorrow morning trying to get people to read and write. I told Martin Luther King, I said, hell, I'm for voting, and we're going to get voting. That's not your problem. You're going to have a voting message, and it's an issue that we can do. The big thing, Dr. King, with you is $1.2 billion for Negroes only. Because who the hell do you think makes less than $2,000 a year? It's the Negroes. Now, thank God they can't work in a filling station, put water in a radiator unless they can read and write. Because they got to go and punch their cash register. They don't know which one to punch. And they got to take a check. They don't know which one to cash. And they got to take a credit card. And they can't pull the numbers. So you got to teach them read and write. And that's what you damn fellas better be working on. And if these Republicans want to be for the Negroes, and I hope they do, I want them. Two-party system. I hope some Negroes vote for Republicans. But you make them go vote for education. And I think you ought to find out this group that's meeting with Ms. Green and as Vice President of the United States, you ought to ask two of them to come to your home on Sunday afternoon. You ought to have two of them at breakfast with you on Monday morning. You ought to have two of them in your office in the afternoon and give them a card to the gallery and give them a picture of you and your wife and give one of the president. And then tell them that this is the greatest thing, and their names are going to be built to be written in fire on every schoolhouse in the country that they've made the breakthrough. And the Pope don't get a damn thing out of this but a pencil. And then the school board's got to give it to him, and that you're a Protestant, and that this is the best thing you've ever seen, because if you can't do more than old Lady Green, I'm in a hell of a shape. I ought to have had her.
Yes, sir, Mr. President.
And if she'd been a little younger, I might have picked her. Goodbye.
Goodbye.